Eugene Tan. I run a website which is called aquabumps.com. I get up every morning, I take pictures down the beach. I put those pictures on my website and email them out to my database, which is, you know, it's about 40,000 these days. And it's a great start to the day, especially when you see sunrises like this morning. I normally end up swimming. It's a good start to the day. No question, it's a good job. You've got to kind of make a job like this, though. No one will give it to you. It's just after 6 o'clock in the morning. All these people down here right now will have a desk job or somewhere to go, so they can do an hour's exercise and, you know, do their normal routine in the morning exercise. They go for a swim, go to a cafe, and they're in the city by 8:30. And they'll probably end up back on the beach by 7 o'clock tonight and they can do something else. It's a pretty good life. It's a good life balance, I think. There'll be like 1,000 people here. Should we go in? There's no one else for miles. Love is on the way. If I could bottle up the sea breeze, I would take it over to your house and pour it loose through your garden, so the hinges on your windows would rust and color like the boats pulled up on the sand for the summer. And your sweet clean closet goes stiff on the line, and there'd be sand in your pockets and nothing on your mind. Oh.
So this particular area, Paddington on Glenmore Road, houses an abundance of different fashion designers and galleries, great little cafes. But the designers are either up and coming or more established.
Paddington's changed considerably over the years. Originally it was a lower middle class, lots of small terraces and dwellings, and now it's far more fashionable area to live.
Fashion in Sydney is relaxed, it's laid back. It's edgy, fashion forward, but still got that Sydney vibe. It's quite unique to the rest of the world. So we're sitting at Fratelli Paradiso.
Here in Potts Point.
Potts Point on Charles Avenue.
Really, really great metropolitan vibe. It's really close to the city, 5 minutes, 10 minutes walk that way, and then up into King's Cross in the other direction. It's traditionally the red light district, and in recent times it's been quite gentrified.
Yeah.
We're quite an international city, although we're geographically not close to the rest of the world. We really, a lot of people come in and out of Sydney, more so now than ever.
G'day, I'm Chris Radburn. We're here at Double Bay, and this hotel is the Golden Sheaf Hotel. Let's go and have a look and grab a beer. It's been here about since about 1936, I guess, 1930s. And it's a place that everyone's always come to in Sydney. It's, in the eastern suburbs, it's always been a place to have a, you know, have a drink. And you have a feed over here, which is the bistro, which is always a really good food. But you can still come here with family, you know. You've got your little kids walking around as well. So it caters for everybody. So this is a local place. Tourists wouldn't be finding this place because they'd look at their brochure and I'd tell them to go to the Rocks. So they're missing out on something that's just really Aussie. We'll grab a couple of beers anyway. I'm a country town. It's like 10,000 people. It's called Cnngo. It's beef capital of New South Wales. And we have a festival called Beef Week. And they have like a parade of bulls, you know, through the streets, and they have bulls in the pubs, and it's like it's huge, and that's why I left as soon as I could. I mean, mateship is a big deal in Australia, and it's all about your mates and you know, playing sport and having a beer and just having a good time. But it's grown out at such an angle that the shears aren't sharp. You got a straight straighten up.